in there.
Just one. Are you the great Anthony Powell?
Well, who might you be?
That's not important.
By what right you come breaking into my
private... By what right you barricade yourself behind closed doors and refuse to see people?
That happens to be none of
your
business.
Do you know the girl just fainted in your outer office because you broke an appointment with her?
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
As long as you keep that door closed, you'll never know anything. You're a producer, you ought to see people. Why, the greatest actress in the world might be living out there, 15 feet away from you, and you'd never even give her a chance.
Are you the greatest actress in the world?
Never mind about me. I don't need you, but those other girls do. They sweat and slave and go without food and decent clothes in the hope that someday someone like you will come out of his office and notice them.
I'm sorry, Mr. Powell. That young woman rushed in before I could stop her.
It's all right, Miss Arden. What happened to the girl that fainted?
She's fine. Her friends are taking her home.
I'll ring when I want you.
Thank you.
Sit down, young lady. I want to have a talk with you.
Go ahead.
All right, Sonny.
Yes, sir.
Sit down.
All right, I'm sitting.
Now, listen, my militant friend. I judge from your attitude that you hold me personally responsible for any possible tragedy in the lives of the girls that come up here. Is that correct?
No, it isn't. But I think you ought to see those people. Maybe they've got something.
Well, maybe they have. Do you realize that if I saw all of the girls that came up here, that I wouldn't have time for anything else?
80,000 times.
Every year, about 50,000 girls...
Yes,
will you please
I know.
Sit down? You're
yes,
making
I'm
me nervous.
Sitting. Say something weird.
Every year, about 50,000 girls decide that they want to go on the stage for one reason or another. Well, 49,500 of them are wrong. They'd be much better off home washing dishes.
How about the other 500? Do you see them?
Well, I couldn't see them if I wanted to. There are at least 50 girls for every job.
How do you know you get the right one? You haven't even the common courtesy to go out there and say no to them. At least that would give them some contact with the theater.
Well, you're one that can't complain. I've seen you, and you're not the type.
You're very smug, Mr. Powell. Very smug.
Well, whether or not you're satisfied that I'm not entirely responsible for all of the ills of the theatrical profession, may I suggest that you run along and leave me alone with my conscience?
I doubt if you have a conscience.
Miss Arden.
Yes, Mr. Powell.
I won't see anybody else today. I don't care who. Oh, is he here? Well, hello, Mr. Carmichael. Come in.
Hello, Mr. Powell.
Glad to see you. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
I hope this has nothing to do with that that other matter. I thought that was all settled.
Oh, no, it isn't anything like that.
Well, that's fine. Sit down.
Thank you.
Have a cigar?
No, thanks.
Cigarette?
No.
We just have a little excitement around here.
Yes, I couldn't help it here. Who's the girl?
Oh, I haven't the faintest idea. Some stage-struck damsel suffering from overexcitement.
Is she an actress?
If she is, she's a pretty bad one. I can tell them a mile off.
You're sure of that?
Well, I seldom miss. Something ought to be done about these girls that come to New York and try to go on the stage. They'd be so much better off at home raising families.
That's what my client thinks.
Client?
Oh, you're producing a new play shortly, aren't you?
Enchanted April. Why?
Well, the client I just spoke of is somewhat interested in the theater. Uh-huh. I can't mention any names, of course. You know how those people are, but... Somewhere, he got the idea that he'd like to dabble in show business.
Well, fresh money is always welcome.
Under the circumstances, I'm not so sure that you would be interested.
Under what circumstances?
However, here's a proposition. We may as well go over it. Afterwards, if you're still interested, we can go on from there.